We're in conversation with major American companies now that are either in Venezuela or, in the case of Citgo, here in the United States. I think we're trying to get to the same end result here. You know, Venezuela is one of the three countries I called the troika of tyranny.
Fuck!
It'll make a big difference to the United States economically if we could have American oil companies.
Vlog from 2008 is a snapshot of late 2000s internet culture, taken within the twilight of the torture porn phase of the horror genre. The likes of Saw and Hostel had already outstayed its welcome by this point, and diminishing returns were inevitable. So films of this kind started to implement a snuff idea of doing things in order to refresh the shock value. It did not work, because who in the fuck has heard of this film? However, the producers of this film came up with a pretty neat idea and capitalized with a capital C upon the burgeoning viral market of the time and promoted vlog through a series of vlogs. Pretty unique marketing strategy for the time. However, the proof of the pudding is in the eating, and I report that vlog is not that much the groundbreaking extreme horror experience it promotes itself as being. What it really is, actually, is a mid-2000s standard serial killer film in the vein of something like The Hillside Strangler, coupled with a half-baked character piece of a late 2000s blogger. The film is very much of its time, but does not seem as warmly nostalgic as one would hope. Maybe in due part to the toxicity of the current social media scene, but Vlog feels very desperate at times with all of its grabs towards cultural relevancy. On top of this, the social media framing of this narrative leaves a lot to be desired and opens the film up to many plot holes and continuity errors. However, there is competent stylish direction by Joshua Butler, a solid central performance by Brooke Marx, and plenty of impressive fake snuff gore to balance out those negatives. And overall, I can say that Vlog is an interesting and unique pairing of the found footage and serial killer subgenres of horror that is unfortunately too episodic in pace to warrant a second viewing. Appearing from its UK DVD packaging as an unfriended ripoff, imagine my surprise when I found out that this film, originally titled as The Den, was released in Russia months before Unfriended hit cinemas, and that it also turned out to be a much superior film than Unfriended. Unfriended was done in real time and had some supernatural crap in it. The whole thing was meandering, far-fetched, and sluggish. Hacked is not without its fair share of plot holes and tiresome jump scares, but it has a brisk pace, it sustains tension, and grafts tried and tested paranoia thriller tropes onto its unique chat room concept, which, though dilutes some of the vermicillitude, does actually guarantee a story being told which is not universal amongst found footage films. In the end, I was surprised and impressed by Hacked and found it to be an engrossing and inventive thriller. At least I thought that until the end, where it gets really, really fucking stupid for the pitiful sake of dog whistling to horror fans. Hey, this is still for you! Fucking hell. It feels cheap and forced and becomes more of a trashy found footage film than the taut paranoia thriller it was convincingly being till the third act. True, throughout there are implausibilities, but the tonal shift in the third act was nothing short of jarring and ruined the film's impact a great deal. Because of this, I recommend Hacked to horror fans looking for something unique, but does not drastically reinvent the wheel. Based on a fascinating true story, You Want Me to Kill Him is a miserable, dread-inducing slice of Skins-flavored social realism set in 2003, in the early days of social networking, when everyone was more ignorant of their digital footprint and less cynical in their interactions with others, and whether that's a good thing or not is up for debate considering all that has happened since then. You Want Me to Kill Him is a well-acted, well-shot, well-scripted British drama that I'm surprised I haven't heard of before. At times, it is a painful watch as characters make very believable decisions, manipulated in ways that are all too familiar in the modern age. You have probably heard a story like this before, the young and the ignorant, the bored and the callous. Such stories have the ability to severely cripple your faith in humanity. You Want Me to Kill Him excels at prodding at this faith, mixing together solid chemistry between actors with direction that near effortlessly provokes paranoia. Films like You Want Me to Kill Him are the reason why Britain is considered to be a drama powerhouse. It's realistic, emotional, and at times, truly harrowing. It is an exceptional work. Right, just to sum up, I recommend Vlog as a time capsule into late 2000s horror and nothing more. I recommend Hacked as a unique and only slightly stupid paranoia thriller. And finally, I recommend You Want Me to Kill Him as just a superb piece of drama. A real find. It's well worth your time.